Now, it might well not be your particular cup of tea, but it's the journey of a lifetime for one American chap who has come back to Ireland, to this rugged landscape, to ride on horseback from here, Castletownbere and West Cork, right up the west as far as Donegal. And Nationwide was on hand to see off this particular American cowboy as he rode off into the Wild West.
Food for thought and sustenance as Steady prepares to go out on the range for her long journey into the Wild West of Ireland.
Hello, Steady. Are you getting ready? Oh, no. Good boy.
Yes.
Good. From Dunboy Stables, Don St. John is about to saddle up and embark on a journey of a lifetime, a five-month trip from Cork to Donegal.
Hello, Eamonn.
How are you doing, Don? You're all set?
I am set.
That's good.
It's been a long time in planning, but...
You're finally getting there.
We're ready to go.
Well, he wrote me a letter a little over a year ago expressing an interest in taking a trip around Ireland on horseback. And basically he asked me if I had any suitable horses which would fulfil his needs. And if so, to write him back with the details. So I did that. And I suppose in all honesty, I expected that was the last of it, like, you know. And then I got a phone call then, I suppose, about Easter time of this year. And to say that he was in Ireland, staying in Bunratty Castle. And that he'd like to come down and take a look at the horses.
Well, I'll give you a ring anyway.
Let me know how you're getting on.
And I'm sure, no problem.
With a new horse and new friends, the adventure is about to begin.
Oh. Eamonn, take care of yourself and the horses and enjoy your adventures.
Thank you.
Take care, Steady.
On our way.
Okay, we'll see you then.
Why on earth, Don, are you going around Ireland on a horse?
Well, it's an adventure I've been thinking about for a while. And what I wanted to do is see Ireland at a slow pace. I used to live in the north and was worked up there back in the early 80s and never had the time to really see Ireland. So I decided to do this trip, but at first I was worried about how I would handle all the gear, like what I have up here. And then I thought, hey, let's do it on horseback.
So have you done a lot of travelling and have you worked with a lot of horses?
Yes, I've owned horses for about 10 years, and when I was a young boy, I did quite a bit of riding.
You look like an American cowboy, and it's kind of ironic that you're going to travelling the Wild West, so to speak, of Ireland.
That's true, good point. Yeah, I've been around horses most of my life and I've owned them. I owned 10 horses back in the 70s, but as recently as the late 80s, I did some cowboy cattle roundups. I met a man out in Utah, and every fall I would go out there and spend a week or week and a half helping him round up his wild longhorn cattle. So the west of Ireland is just kind of the same way, but the cattle aren't quite as wild. Are these your animals?
Yeah.
Oh, this is kind of like a zoo. And you take care of them and feed them?
Yeah.
Oh, that's grand. Well, you have a good day.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
A brief chat, and it's on the road again, where Don expects to meet all shades of Irish life.
The ruggedness of the country and the people. And again, going at a slow pace, I hope to see both and meet a lot of people along the way and probably stop at a few towns and have a pint or two.